It's lonely when everyone's sleeping and you're awake. I don't get that gap, that break in life, that 7 to 8 hours where people are asleep and they're not thinking about anything. I'm up, I'm thinking. Sometimes I cook if it's not too loud. Got a muffin recipe down pat where I don't have to use beaters. I've tried the sleep hygiene thing where you get up and you sit in a quiet room and you wait for your next REM cycle, and I've tried all that. I'm over it. It's boring, especially when it doesn't work. I'm tired constantly. I get irritable. Every time I've approached a doctor, it's sleeping tablets. Yeah, they knock me out, or like just side effects like grogginess the next day. I don't feel very good. Some of them are addictive, so I don't really want to go there.
Yeah, hang on.
In a few months' time, Kate will graduate as a nurse.
Get him one on the insulin.
I know firsthand that shift work has a big impact on sleep and mental health.
And what do they say? 10 years off your life as a shift worker.
So how are you going to cope, Kate, when you've got a early, a late, and then a couple of night duties?
I don't know. That's why I'm doing this study, because it needs to... I need to fix it. It's been 20 years.
It's really passionate what you're doing.
We're going to press start on the machine, and that's going to record your heart rhythm.
For medical staff, severe fatigue can have life and death consequences.
This is my last hope, a last-ditch effort, really, to fix it. Everything's riding on it, my family life, my health, mental, physical, emotional health, and also my career.